Fire in the hole.
Season 2 starting with a bang.
Elbow.
Boom.
I like it. I like that a lot. SOARNEX spends a lot of time working with our military. Survival Tactical Systems is another company that they're also working a lot with and become close friends. Getting a chance to go shoot some guns and play around and learn from some of these guys is an opportunity I've been looking for. Bert, why don't you introduce us to your friends here?
This is Nick Koumalatsos from STS, former MARSOC operator, helping us out with a lot of the guns and teaching us all the techniques and just being pretty much a badass. And over here we have Taco. Taco is awesome at being Taco and bringing us some amazing armament.
One of the toys that was brought out for us to play with is a can cannon. It's exactly what it sounds like. It's an upper for the AR-15 that shoots an aluminum can about 100 yards. So we're gonna give a couple test runs here. Taco brought a can cannon. Now we're going to turn 10 roof beers into ammo. No, you go first one. See what happens. Holy cow!
That was awesome.
Well,
nice!
Woo! That's so great.
Oh.
I'd like to thank X Products for sending us the can cannon and Palmetto State for providing plenty of ammo for us to play with all day. I love learning new things in the weight room, but learning new things anywhere I can is also amazing. Nick, working with Survival Tactical Systems, a lot of expertise in this area, so he worked on some of my handgun abilities and trying to get better at that. I'm getting a chance to work with Nick, learn some better pistol marksmanship, so. Better be better at what you're shooting at, Nick.
Absolutely. So we're gonna focus on some grip and trigger control, sight alignment, sight picture. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna have you shoot on your own.
Okay.
I'm just gonna watch, see what you do, and then I'm gonna make corrections and we're gonna shoot again.
Awesome.
Point it pops. Now, if a laser beam came out of your finger, would it hit him?
Yes.
Why?
Because it's straight at him? Because the back of my finger and the front of my finger?
Because human anatomy.
Okay.
Because we automatically line up. If I'm 25 feet away from you and I point at you, it's gonna hit you.
Okay. Right?
And that's just because of the way our brain and body lines up. So we want to do the same thing with shooting. All right. So when we come out, what I want you to do is have a high firm pistol grip, okay? With your index finger, your shooting finger, pointing at the target, okay? Straighten off the trigger like we talked about.
Right.
Safety rules, okay? And then wrap it around here. All right, you're gonna take your support hand, and you're gonna marry those palms up. And you see where my gap is?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, slightly canted. And now look at my thumbs.
On top of each other.
And if a round came out of my thumbs, where's it going?
Straight at target as well.
Right aligned with the barrel. So everything's lined up. There's no gap in my hands, okay, and everything's wrapped around. So what I'm doing is I'm pretty much giving a 60-40 push. So 60-40 push pull.
Okay.
Okay. Now see how you did there with your thumbs crossed. Like you'll see a lot of this. Okay.
So I want both down.
Right. You want them lined up. Okay. You'll see some weird stuff like this. Like you'll see like the thumbs up. All right. So all you want to do is lining them up right here, all right? And this, if you notice, my grip is completely, I'm eating the pistol.
Yeah, right.
Eating, I'm owning it. And what that does is for recoil management, you know, as you take a round,
you're back on target quicker.
Right. And this gun is an extension of your body. And let's rotate this one just a little bit forward. There we go. That's it right there.
And then just move to trigger?
Two shots. One out of two. Okay, so this time what we're gonna do, all right, so this time when you pull the trigger, I want you to hold it to the rear instead of letting all the way off.
Okay.
So we're gonna pull the trigger, hold it to the rear, slowly let it out until it clicks, and then slowly squeeze again. So this time what I want you to do is I want you to square up to the target. All right? And what I'm gonna say is I'm gonna say feet, knees, hips, shoulders. So feet, same thing like our thumbs. We want our toes pointing at the target.
Okay.
Because that lines our body up. All right, knees slightly bent, hips bent forward at the waist. All right, so basically you're gonna do a squat. So you're gonna stick your ass out, and then you're gonna roll your shoulders forward. So you're just gonna come down. When I come up, I'm rolling in, and I'm squeezing this in.
Okay.
Feel how tight that is?
Oh yeah.
All right, let's take another shot. So same body position, feet, knees, hips, shoulders, okay? We're gonna have that solid grip, 60-40 split.
Mm-hmm.
Proper trigger control. We're gonna squeeze, let off the trigger, and then squeeze again, all right? And what we're gonna do is we're just gonna go down the line. The first can on the right,
mm-hmm.
You're gonna hold the trigger to the rear once you shoot, move to the next target, let the trigger reset, then squeeze again, hold it,
steal.
Hit the steel, so on and so on.
All right.
Feel a difference?
Yeah, I'm tired now.
What are you doing anything?
That's harder than it. Just got a John Woo a little. You know, I can also tell the difference in, you know, shooting that way 4 days a week and building that specific position, that motor memory, boom, you're already.
So what happens, let's talk about a legitimate life or death scenario. So if you train that way to where your body, everything that I'm doing, my toes, my body, you know, my arms is, you know, to a threat. So you train your muscle memories towards this target and you're training this way. And you're working on your draw, you're working on your side alignment, side picture. You're building this muscle memory in your head to where when an incident happens, you just react.
Right.
But everything's lined up. You're not going to be looking at your sights. What's going to happen is you're going to pull your gun and your body's going to completely line up everything it's supposed to do. And with your thumbs, your toes, your shoulders, everything, and what's gonna happen?
You hit the target.
You're gonna hit the target.
Yeah.
You know, and that's the reason why we train that way.
That's so awesome.
You know, all the other kind of stuff.
Man, I appreciate the help. That's huge. Yeah. I got something to go home with. After that quick lesson, we got a chance to play with some Tannerite. Chris brought this out for us to play with. Amazing stuff to blow up. Do it safely, enjoy yourself.
Four white composition and empty one foil catalyst bag. So we have the composition and the catalyst bag. And that's all we know. They say that you're supposed to have a weapon shooting 2,000 feet per second or more, but that's not true. Take it too much, it'll just go boom. You gotta be careful with it.
Alright.
You shake?
Yeah, that
bothers. There you go.
See?
Yeah, but so without it being all together, will it work through container to container?
We're gonna find out.
Yeah.
I like that type of logic.
Holy crap. Yes.
So we have any idea if shooting one of them will blow up the other ones?
Should.
Okay. The compression should be enough. That's pretty cool.
Yeah. That was rad.
That's pretty cool. Getting to travel and meet awesome people is what this whole series has been about. I don't care what it is, as long as they're passionate people and doing awesome stuff, I'm down to give it a go. Thanks again for all the sponsors. Check the links below and you can find your own cam cannon and blow some stuff up, safely of course. Tune in next time, 2 weeks, we're gonna have Reese Hoffa, bronze medal shot putter, one of the best the U.S. has ever had. You're gonna learn what pushes him to do the things he does.
Hey there, click subscribe, like, leave some comments, and check out Drift to Lift It every 2 weeks while I'm sitting here struggling.